Hello and welcome. I'm Amanda. I'm a naturopath and a physical therapist, and I have specialized in Pilates for both fitness and for rehabilitation for about 20 years now. So I've had my own business, my own Pilates studio, for about 17 years. And today, I am going to share my 5 best tips for starting your own Pilates business. So whether you're interested in maybe a little side hustle, something to do part-time in the evenings, weekends, or maybe you're wanting to jump ship from your current day job and just start a full-blown, full-time Pilates business, I'm hoping that these tips are helpful for you, they will inspire you and educate you and motivate you to chase after your dreams in a smart, realistic way. Number one tip for starting a Pilates business is simply to start small. So no matter how excited or enthusiastic you are or what your end goals entail, just start small. To fill a Pilates studio with professional quality Pilates equipment can cost you $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 or more dollars. It's very expensive to invest in studio quality equipment. Now, when they are quality pieces, they're gonna last you a lifetime. You can have clients working out on them all day long and they'll take a beating and they're gonna be fine. So that's great. However, it's really expensive and you don't need it. You can start with very few items and begin teaching your clients and helping them. So I am not a debt kind of girl. I'm a Dave Ramsey girl. So if you don't already have an established client base and you don't have the cash saved up, I say don't do it. It's not worth going thousands or tens of thousands of dollars into debt and having that pressure on you before you've even started your business or teaching Pilates. That's kind of crazy to me. You don't need to do that. So start small. You can start with a mat, an exercise mat, or a square of carpet, okay? You don't really need anything. You can just start with your body weight for Pilates. But you can also do a lot with some really inexpensive small props, whether that's adding in magic circle, light weights, foam rollers, physio balls, medicine balls, what have you. There's all kinds of little inexpensive, really affordable, and portable items that you can use to start your Pilates business. You can help your clients, you can teach them a lot of things, you can get a great workout, and you can build from there. So get your client base going, work with your clients, build relationships with them, get some business through word of mouth. And then as you have the funds and you have the space, the resources, and you've figured out that you actually love doing this and you want to do this, then you can check into some equipment. My number two tip for starting a Pilates business is to offer an attractive price. That sounds really common sense, but if you're new and you're coming up against a bunch of established studios or other instructors that may or may not be in your area, you can check that out. Then do a little research, find out what they're charging. Private and semi-private training for Pilates, even group apparatus classes, can be really pricey. So you can do yourself a huge favor if you just cut your price by like $5 or $10. Or maybe you offer like a new client deal. Or a package, an introduction package, or if they buy a group of classes, a reduced rate, something that's going to get somebody to come into your studio when you're kind of new and not as established. Maybe you don't have a relationship with that client yet, but so that they'll give you a try. Maybe you offer just a free trial class and have them in, or go out into your community or stream some free group classes so they can get to know you a little bit, your style, and see if it's a good fit for them. So once you get them in the door, because you've offered that attractive price and they can see that you're skilled and you're a good match as a teacher and a student, then maybe after they've get through a package and some classes, then you think about raising your prices if needed. And eventually there's no reason why you can't have, even if you're a home-based studio like I am, there's no reason why you can't have prices equal to or maybe even higher than local studios. But to start out with, to get those clients in and to build your client base, offer an attractive price or an attractive deal, something that's gonna make them want to give you a try. My number three tip, it's really similar to my number one tip of starting small, and keep your overhead low. So that's a tip not just for starting out, but for always. So Again, I've had a home Pilates studio, my business, for 17 years. And there was definitely a point in time where I had a bustling studio, lots of clients coming, and I started looking at commercial property. I thought, you know what? I've outgrown my home. I'm going to take this out into the community. I got all the figures and everything. And what I found was, in order to earn a profit, I had to teach pretty much as I was teaching at home, just to cover all the expenses of rent and utilities and what I was going to need to furnish and set up another space. So I would have to work that and then some to even earn a profit. And so it wasn't worth it to me. And I realized that, that's one way you can expand, but I tell you what, right now in the time of the global pandemic, I'm happy I'm working from home. I have a very intimate studio. I've been able to continue to see clients safely, and it's worked out really well for me. So keep your overhead low. If that means perhaps you can set up a space in your house, maybe you can travel to your clients' areas, maybe you do outdoor Pilates in a park, maybe you rent out a room in like a community center or a library or a school or a church, something like that, and get the word out that way. You could meet and you could do group classes, you could do private classes or small group classes, and you could still earn an income and get experience and have very, very low overhead. And that means there's more money in your pocket. It means you can work less and make more. And that is a great thing. Fourth tip for starting a Pilates business is to maintain a flexible schedule. So when you're trying to build your business, and again, if you don't have a lot of clients, like if you don't already have an established client base that you're bringing with you and you're needing to get business, then you're gonna have to work around your client schedules. And whether that's fortunate or unfortunate, a lot of times that means evening classes, weekends. So for me, when I started out, that worked out really well because I had babies at home and I was watching little kids and babies all day long. So it was perfect for me to work kind of the non-traditional business hours and teach in the evenings. I taught Saturdays for about 15 years. So that worked out really well for my schedule. Now that my kids are older and they're in school, I can work more during the day, morning, afternoons. I still work some evenings though. So maintaining that flexibility in your schedule and really being able to accommodate those new clients. And in time, you'll be able to consolidate them and you'll be able to get a little bit more particular about when you want to work. And that's one of the wonderful things about having your own business is having that flexibility of your schedule, being able to take off when you want to take off. You don't need permission for that. When you're the boss, you can arrange your own schedule. But in the beginning, it's helpful to really try to be accommodating when people can come in. And final tip for starting your Pilates business is to over-serve. Customer service is everything, as with most service-related businesses, right? Well, it's just the same in Pilates. You want to over-serve. You want to bend over backwards for your clients, particularly when you're building a business. Always, you should always do that to keep your clients happy, but overserve. They're coming to you and they are paying you a good amount of money, for you to take care of them and to help them, and that's what you should do. You should have your phone turned off, notifications on your watch turned off. You should have your focus on your client. You shouldn't be thinking about what you need to do later that day or what you're gonna have for dinner that night. You need to tune in and make sure that they know that you are listening to them, you are hearing them, and you're there to help them. You're there to serve them. It's not just about earning money. It's about, this industry is about helping people. It's about helping people to feel better, to look better, feel better, gain confidence, all of those great things. And Pilates really can carry over into a lot of areas of your life. So you're there to help that person. When I began, there wasn't really a lot of social media and online stuff. It wasn't quite so easy to hop on and build a website or have a Facebook business page, any of that kind of thing. So I didn't do any of that, but because I worked from home, I didn't really want to advertise. I didn't want to put something in the newspaper or something like that. Just because people were coming into my home, my kids were at home, and I just wanted to make sure I felt really safe and that I trusted who was coming into my house. So all of my business was built through word of mouth. And I think that that is the best. That is the best way to build your business, because when you have clients that you love and trust, and then they refer you to their neighbor, to their sister, to their brother, their mom, their dad, their friend, whoever, you know, they come in and they let you know, hey, I passed your name on to so-and-so. You might be hearing from them. And then you trust. There's that connection, and it's much more comfortable. It's just a very organic and wonderful way to develop your business. So you get the word of mouth business by over-serving your clients. Make sure your clients are happy with the service that you are delivering to them. Always give them 110%. And you are sure to build a successful business. And because they're going to be so happy, it's going to be more rewarding for you. So having a Pilates business is rewarding on so many levels for me. It's not just financial benefit. I love getting to help people with something that I'm passionate about, and you get to see it just filter through so many areas in their life, and it's wonderful to be a witness of that, and also knowing they've done the hard work. It's really them, you know, it's on them. They get all of the props, right? But you know that you had a hand in that. You guided that process, and so it's a really wonderful thing to witness. So in summation, my 5 tips for starting a Pilates business, whether it's a little side hustle or a full-blown gig. 1, start small. 2, offer an attractive price or deal to get those clients in your door. 3, keep your overhead low. And that's for for always, okay? The lower you can keep your cost, then the more money you're going to make. The less you're gonna have to work to make that money. So that's a win. 4, maintain a flexible schedule. Be accommodating. And along with that, over-serve. Offer the best customer service that you possibly can. So I hope you found this helpful, and I wish you the very best of luck if this is something you're considering doing. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. And best of luck for you. Thanks for joining.